Hey guys, what's up? So I'm back with another awesome series for you guys that will be called as Learning Aids. Since we keep on studying, we've been studying since we were 3-4 year kid, and now we are grown up adults. Still, most of us do not know how to study. They come to me and say, sir, you have an awesome memory, and why, like, you are, I am also human, very much like you, but I know certain tricks in my bag, which I'll be sharing with you now on how to study effectively. So it will be presented by me. This is the YouTube channel Unacademy. So if you want to read more about me, you can go to my Facebook page, that is facebook.com/romansani.official. Due to certain reasons, I'll not be able to take messages now. So it'll take me at least 1 week before the message button is enabled again. So sorry for that. Before you do anything, you must know, you should learn how to learn. This is the most important question. No one teaches us how to learn. They just keep saying read. We used to do rote learning while you were kid, and we are still continuing with the same thing. This is not the way. This is absolutely wrong. So rote learning has to be done, but only in certain part. Let's say 10-20% of the thing has to be rote memorized, but majority of the thing need not be rote learning. This is the important point we should be taking home, my dear friends. So we start. So why do we need learning aids at all? So what is the purpose of having learning aids? See, the first thing first is we have limited memory capacity, as we must be knowing by now that our brain is not having an infinite potential to store everything we read. By the time you will finish reading anything, only 18-20% of that will be stored in your head. And if you do not revise, it will be like 5%. So if you really need these learning aids to make an impact, then there is an evolution, there is a concept called evolution, do read about it. So there is an evolutionary limit on our cognitive abilities. We can only do so many things at times. We can't do everything under the sun and expect that it will stick to us for rest of our lives. It's simply impossible. So we are not supposed to remember numbers and facts. See, this is also the thing, that 10,000 years ago, while we were looking for food, so we were not like very much into numbers and 12 ki table yaad karne ki utti ichcha nahi hoti thi. The thing is that until 10,000 years ago, the social is developed like anything, but our mental capability is exactly the same. It is more or less the same as that of a man who was, let's say, there 5,000 years ago or 10,000 years ago. Evolution takes time. So we are not supposed to remember numbers and facts and tables and wars and all. However, our brain is extremely awesome when it comes to pattern recognition. Pattern recognition, agar tiger hai, if there is a tiger behind a certain tree all the time, so your brain will know and you'll avoid that tree from next time onwards. Similarly, there is a bushes, a gathering of fruits and all, and deers at a particular location, so your brain will remember the path. It is called as conditioning. So if you taste a fruit and it's bitter and you fell ill, so your brain will be conditioned not to eat that fruit ever again in life. Similarly, there is pegging. Pegging means, let's say you have gone to a place where there are 2-3 deers. So you'll always remember that place, and whenever that place's name pops up, you'll remember deer. So that is why we need learning aids. So what will be the topics which will be covered in this learning aid series? First of all, remembering a list, which will be done in this particular video. And then there will be mnemonics. Then how to quadruple, that is 4 times your speed of reading and retaining. Then if you can read 4 times faster, then you also need to know how to read, revise and retain efficiently. Then I'll teach you something I called as mind maps, and then I'll teach you how to make notes. These are the topics which I think, if you still want me to do on something else, do let me know also. So remembering a list, why remembering a list is important? Because this is the single biggest problem. Example, remembering shopping list as well as in academics. For shopping list, you can write down on a piece of paper, you can write down on your cell phone, there are so many apps for it. But in academics, you simply cannot take your phone into the hall classroom, in the exam room. So I'll teach you within 10 minutes how to remember a list. You'll remember not only the name in the list, but the most important thing is you'll remember the exact order where they are on the list. So let's say there is a 4th thing. So you'll be able to remember what is on the 4th point, what is on the 7th point, what is on the 11th point, without even going through the entire list. And you just need 30 seconds or 1 minute maximum. You can ask your friend to say 10 random stuff, toothpaste, laptop, trousers, anything. And it has to be a gap of 3-4 seconds each, and you'll remember them. Just see, your brain is so wonderful, and I'll unleash the potential of your brain with this video. So just watch. First thing first, you have to remember this rhyme. This rhyme is extremely important, over which the entire situation is there. So 1 is sun, 2 is shoe, 3 is tree, 4 is boar, that is wild pig or something like that, 5 is hive, दैट इज हनी बीज हनी, सिक्स इज स्टिक्स, सेवन इज हेवन, एट इज गेट, नाइन इज लाइन एंड टेन इज हैन. सो डू रिवाइज दिस वंस अगेन एंड देन इफ यू कैन वॉन्ट टू पॉज इट यू कैन पॉज इट हेयर. सो आई विल टीच यू हाउ टू रिमेंबर मिलेनियम डेवलपमेंट गोल्स. सो दे वर डन इन 1990 ब्ला 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 बट वी टेंड टू फॉरगेट ऑल दी एट गोल्स. सो देर आर एट गोल्स. सो हाउ डू आई रिमेंबर इट? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टू इरेडिकेट एक्सट्रीम पॉवर्टी एंड हंगर. सो आई इमेजिन देर इज अ स्कॉर्चिंग सन समवेयर एंड इट्स लाइक द अर्थ इज टोटली पर्ज्ड एंड देर आर पीपल हु आर जस्ट लुकिंग फॉर एनीथिंग टू ईट. सो द सन इज सो स्ट्रांग नथिंग इज एबल टू ग्रो देयर. सो दैट इज लीडिंग टू पॉवर्टी एंड हंगर. सो दिस इज आवर रिमेंबर द फर्स्ट गोल. Second is like to achieve universal primary education. So I remember Shu. So a child who is not willing to go to school, her mother is beating him with Shu and just asking him to go to the school. So next time I remember Shu in this Millennium Development Goal, I know it has related to something with primary education because children are not willing to go to school, so they have to be beaten up by Shu. It is all in a fun way. So the more the funny the story, the better you will remember. Then the third is, let's say, to promote gender equality and empower women. So I always remember that whenever there is a shadow of a tree, so the half is always like on one half, the woman will be sitting. Let's say the 90% is occupied by male, so woman is pushing them to go in their half. Or both, if there's a tree, there are branches. So one fruit is male, one fruit is female, something like that. So I remember this, like there will be a part of tree, 50% divided here, 50%. So it will be leading to an equal distribution. Then fourth is to reduce child mortality. So I remember there is a hospital scene. A child is almost dying of pneumonia. So you doctor is rushing on a boar. Doctor is sitting on a boar and boar is taking him to that particular hospital to save the child's life. See, these are funny stories and will stick to you. Believe me, it sounds stupid and idiotic, but this is how I remember. And most of my friends who have taught them, they say that this is the most wonderful thing that ever happened to them. Then to improve maternal health. So maternal mother is dying because of anemia and blood loss. So you are actually giving them honey to eat, and also during their pregnancy it strengthens them. So there is a huge line outside a honey shop and they are just feeding honey all to all the pregnant women. This is also funny, but you will remember. Then to combat HIV AIDS malaria, there are a lot of crippling which has happened and people can't walk, so they are taking help of sticks. And we have make sure we have taken a passionate oath to remove those sticks from their hand and to treat them. So that is how I remember sticks. So you'll remember six is sticks, seven is heaven. So heavenly feeling is coming that everything, infinite resources are there. So infinite resources are there. You don't need to worry about anything, water, electricity, everything is available in abundance. So in heaven only this is possible. So it is relating to environmental sustainability or something like that. Then eight is gate. So there are various countries. India has closed its gates with Pakistan, China, USA. So we are all opening these gates, and this will ensure a global partnership between all these countries. So they are metaphorical gates, and you have to remember like this: a gate is opening, a US president is coming, another gate is opening, Pakistan's president is coming, and China's premier is coming, something like that. And there's a very, very funny story, a central hall where all the gates are opening and all the countries are coming to have a global partnership for development. So that understood, the one is sun, two is shoe, three is tree, four is boar, five is hive, six is sticks, seven is heaven, eight is gate, nine is line and ten is hen. So abhi tak there were only eight, so I don't think you will be needing line. Nine is line and ten is hen. So for, let's say, another important topic which comes in mains mein it has been asked twice as it is. So these are the fundamental duties. So always you remember one is sun. So the first will be about constitution, national flag and national anthem. So you just remember all the students are sitting in assembly hall, they are standing, so bright sunshine is there, so it is relating to sun. And we are singing our national anthem with pride, and we are having held our constitution book in one hand. So what is, the sun is so strong that it is burning a hole in our national flag. So we provided cover by throwing the book, so it provides a cover between the flag and the sun. Again, I'm telling you, this sounds very stupid and idiotic, but this is how you will remember. Till now you have practiced it, you still don't remember it. This is the way to remember it. Then to cherish and follow the noble ideals. So we remember, so they are, someone is hurling shoes on statue of great leaders. Shoe is for second. A great leader means noble ideas and national struggle. And but he would do what? You take the same shoe and beat the crap out of him. So this is how it is. So the two is shoe. Then the three is tree. So what you do is, you were standing near a tree. So it is about sovereignty, unity and integrity. So sui, that is sui means needle. Sui means needle in Hindi. So you took a needle and you punched a hole in a tree. Tree was full of air, and as you punched the hole, the entire air came out and the tree dried down. So it's as simple as that. The three is tree. Then four is bore. So to defend the country and render national service and to do upon. So I always remember border and a war. So I don't have any vehicle, but I'm so passionate about my fundamental duty. I'm sitting on a bore and kicking on its sides so that it takes me faster to the border. Then the five is about, just remember this word, that harmony, and to renounce practice derogatory to dignity of women, brotherhood. So anyone who is creating chaos that is against these three things, so what I do is, all of them are standard and they are giving punished by bitten by honeybees. So you'll remember that honeybee is biting someone. Why they are biting them? Because they are against harmony, they are creating chaos, they are against brotherhood, they are doing practices which are derogatory to dignity of the woman. Then six is sticks. So I remember the culture. As soon as I hear the word culture, I remember Taj Mahal. So the Taj Mahal is standing in front rather than on strong foundation. It's standing on support of sticks and it's looking very, very funny. So this is six is sticks. Then seven is heaven. So again, those who people have tortured wildlife and they have done wrong to the environment while they are standing in a queue to go to heaven. Those who have done this, they are not allowed and they are sent to hell. It's as simple as that. Then 8 is gate. So in gate, whatever you remember, so you need to develop scientific temper according to the fundamental duty of the constitution. So inside your head is a gate. Usko aapne khola, you open it and then they throw all the blind beliefs in that gate and closed it. So literally just imagine opening your own brain with a key and then putting all your blind beliefs in that and then literally closing it and eating the key. So this is 8 is gate. Then 9 is line. So anyone who is doing damage to public property or who is creating violence, what we ask them is ask them to stand in a line. If they are not standing in the line, we are beating them, we are punishing them, and we have just tied them with a rope, so they are has to be in a line. So then 10 is hen. So it is all about excellence in individual and collective spheres. So what happens is the hen which India has is probably of low quality. So we breed them with high quality hens and only the excellent hens are produced, best quality hens are produced in the poultry farm. See, there are absolutely no relation, but the relation is as soon as you will remember 10, you will know hen, and hen you will remember excellent, and that is how you will remember this. So this is how your brain will work. So it's called conditioning. Then 11. Now how to remember 11? So this is an important point. So just you remember 1. 1 was sun. So sun se hame yaad aaya, we were singing national anthem, holding constitution book in our hand, and we are throwing it to protect our national flag. So after this is over, what we are doing? We are going to classes, and we are going to classes to attend our education. So this is something like that. So 11th duty relates to education. So it's as simple as that. So now you know 1 has to relate to 11. Similarly, 2 has to relate to 12, 3 is to 13. So is that absolutely understood? So moving forward, so 1 to 10 is done, that is sun, shoe, tree, boar, hive, sticks, heaven, gate, line, hen. For then furthermore, that is 11, 12, 13, 14, you continue the same thing. The sun, as soon as you remember 1, you remember sun. So sun has to do with 11 again. Then 2, that is shoe. So you combine the stories again and again. I don't think you'll be able to remember. You need to remember more than 20, but by using this technique, you can remember up to 100 also in a perfectly fine manner. It will just take you 5-10 minutes. Remember, for rote learning, we takes years and years altogether. Still, most of you are reading it for past 5-6 years, the constitution book I'm talking about. You will not be able to remember fundamental duties. Just by watching this video for 30 seconds or for 1 minute, you will be able to remember fundamental duties, at least the crux. This is the importance and this is the revolutionary concept. So please imbibe in it. So this was it about the video. So the most important thing is, while you are using these tricks and techniques, please do not apply logic. Do not come to me, this is not a way to study, this is not a proven way. Believe me, this is the way how most of the people who are extremely intelligent, they study like this and they remember most of the stuff, and then you question ki how they do it. But when they actually tell you the strategy, like I'm telling you, you'll feel it's not logical. So please do not apply LAR here. LAR meaning logic, analysis and reasoning. That does not work here in memory aids. Then make story as funny, as vivid and as absurd as possible. Insult yourself, humiliate yourself, embarrass yourself, embarrass someone else. Make sure that something which do not make sense at all, which is extremely vivid and strange, colorful, bright, funny, absurd. दैट इज हाउ द स्टोरी शुड बी. एंड डू नॉट मेक रिलेटेड स्टोरीज, प्लीज डू नॉट मेक रिलेटेड स्टोरीज. स्टोरी शुड बी एज नॉन रिलेटेड एज पॉसिबल बिकॉज इट विल कॉज कन्फ्यूजन लेटर ऑन. एंड यू हैव टू बी एज एब्सर्ड एज पॉसिबल. दिस इज अगेन एंड अगेन आई एम एम्फसाइजिंग ऑन इट. इट विल नॉट बी पॉसिबल टू रिमेंबर इट इफ यू आर नॉट एब्सर्ड. So I hope you like this video and you will be able to remember lists better next time. So if you want me to make more videos on learning aids, do let me know, sir and ma'am, because without you letting me know, at least 50 to 100 people have requested me for this video on how to read better and how to remember better. Sir, we read everything, we are not able to remember anything. That is why I thought I'll share these inside trade secrets with you. So if you still want me to make the video, do let me know and please spread the word. Do like, share and subscribe both the Facebook page as well as the YouTube channel. So what happens is, as if you don't share, I don't come to know that many people are watching it, so I get disheartened and I stop making these videos, as simple as that. Because it's time for a little revolution in education. Please make sure that you are part of this revolution. I want you to be in. Then this is the channel. Do click here to subscribe An Academy. Any query, you can ping me at my Facebook page. It after 1 week, not right now. Then this is the Facebook page, romansaini dot official after facebook.com. You can also tweet to me at my Twitter handle at romansaini, simple my name. Do like, share and subscribe. Best of luck. Have an awesome day. Thank you for watching the video.